She started it in 1997. Everyone assumes that it's my mom's name, but it's not. The name comes from the county in Ireland where her family comes from. That's County Clare. And then I believe the rose was just a flower that she liked and it just seemed to go together. And it was, I think, a conscious choice on her part to not have her name involved in it.
Her original goal with it was to be able to give back in a way that was meaningful, in a couple ways. Meaningful to her, but also meaningful to the type of people she wanted to help.
So early on, we adopted a policy of we would not accept unsolicited grants, and that just seemed like a natural progression from how my mom worked. She worked with, like I said, people she knew, relationships with people she knew, organizations that were run by people that she trusted. And I was a social worker here in San Diego, so I started doing the same thing. I sort of knew a little bit about the nonprofit field, and I started working with organizations that I knew. I met Carrie Avery, who's also president of the Durfee Foundation, and they are in LA. She came to speak to our training group and described her sabbatical program that she ran up in LA. And I was listening to her talk, and I was listening to her describe it in this conference room, and it just seemed like something, you know, you get this light bulb, it's like, oh my gosh, my mom would love this.
When my sister brought the idea to us, I liked it, but I was just thinking, well, ultimately, we're just sending people on vacation. And as we dug into it and learned more about it, when that, the idea of how it benefits the organization came up, that's when it really ultimately resonated with me and went, ah, that light bulb was like, this really makes sense.
But didn't have any idea how to do it, how to administer it, how to get it off the ground, how would we do this? You know, I'm basically one person, and how would I do this? So I talked to San Diego Grantmakers and asked Nancy Jameson for basically advice, and she put me in touch with Janine Mason at Fieldstone Foundation.
We met together for the first time on July 3rd, and by November we had IRS approval and we had a program that had been designed based on the work of the Durfee Foundation, who was very generous in sharing all of their resources with us, and we announced the program that November.
It seemed like a natural fit. She wanted to do it, had the sort of infrastructure and the wherewithal to do it, and our foundation had the financial resources to do it, and the idea and the excitement and the enthusiasm.
So let's chat a little bit about kind of the different phases.
We just found a partner who was a really good fit with us, and we were able to make this offering to the network and now to nonprofit leaders in San Diego County and Orange County.
My brother Ted talks about a lot when we conduct another round of interviews and site visits, and we hear the recipients speak of their experiences. Ted and I always talk in the car on the way home, and he says it to me every year. He says, this would be something that mom would just love. He's like, he always repeats that.
The long-term goal was to be more hands-on and not just write a check and say good luck and tell us how it goes. So finding someone like Fieldstone was enormously beneficial. We really couldn't do it without them.